There you have the Taiwan Sport University Arena, site of swimming here, the 29th Summer Universiade in Taipei. First up, it'll be the men's 400-meter freestyle final. This is from last night. There you have the start list. This features a couple former Olympians in Mykhailo Romanchuk of Ukraine, as well as Suri Frolov of Ukraine, who competed at the 2012 Olympics, also won a gold in the 800 meters at Guangzhou in 2015. Jay Lelliott of Great Britain leads on the first touch. He's the defending gold medalist in this event, also won silver back in 2015 in the 800 meters. Lelliott currently ahead of world record pace. We'll see if that can hold. Now Romanchuk has overtaken Lelliott by 1.11 seconds. Romanchuk again will touch and extends his lead. Now nearly a second and a half up on the swimmer from Great Britain. Now Romanchuk, a near 2 second lead, heading towards the wall. There you see the world and Universiade record times. Romanchuk will win gold. Will he break a record? He does, a new Universiade record for Mykhailo Romanchuk of Ukraine. He eclipses the mark set at Belgrade in 2009 of 3 minutes 46.72 seconds, set then by Przemyslaw Stanczyk of Poland. There you see the final results, Romanchuk with the gold medal. Now to the women's 400 meter individual medley relay. Kim Seo-yong of Korea, a 2012 Olympian in London. And Yui Ohashi of Japan won a silver medal at the recent World Aquatics Championships in the 4x200-meter relay. It is Kim in lane 8 with the early lead, but it would be Ohashi that pulls away. There you see her all by herself in the screen. Will she too break a record here tonight? And yes, another Universiade record set. This time it's Yui Ohashi of Japan in a time of 4 minutes 34.40 seconds. Yana Klochkova's time of 4:37.50 from Bangkok in 2007 is now gone. McHugh of the United States in second, and Kim of Korea wins the bronze. Now to the women's 4x100-meter freestyle relay. And now the second swimmers in, the United States in first, Russia second, Canada up in lane one in third. Now Canada way up in lane one with a 23/100ths of a second lead. Canada continues to build on that lead. Russia in second. They're in lane five. The United States in lane four. They are third. There you see some of the Russian fans. Now the anchor leg. Russia overtakes Canada with a half second lead. Brazil now has moved into third spot. There you have Russia still in first, but their lead has dwindled. 9/100ths of a second. Canada right behind. United States back in third spot. There you see Canada up top. Can they touch first for gold? Yes, just ahead of Russia, who will take silver. And the United States will win bronze. For Canada, featuring Kathleen Savard, who won gold in the 2013 World University Games in the 100-meter butterfly. She has a gold here with her teammates, just ahead of Russia and the United States. Now the final medal from last night at swimming. This is the men's 4x100 meter freestyle relay. Ryan Held of the United States won a gold medal in this very event at the Rio Olympics last year with teammate Michael Phelps. The defending gold medalists in this event here at Universiade are the Americans. Japan won silver and Russia won bronze back in Guangzhou. Right now though, it's Poland in lane two, just ahead of Japan. Very close. There, Poland still in front, just ahead of the United States. Russia in third, 32/100 back. But now the U.S. overtakes Poland. Italy in second. Brazil has moved up into third spot. And the Americans starting to stretch that lead. Now a second and a half ahead of the Japanese. Justin Lynch will swim the anchor leg here for the United States. And the United States will win gold. It'll be a battle for silver and bronze. United States, in a time of 3:14.01, will win the gold medal for the second straight year. Italy will claim silver in a time of 3:15.24, and Russia, just behind in third spot, will win the bronze medal. So busy night at the pool on day one. Competition continues on day two with more medals. There is the Nangang Exhibition Center here in Taipei. Site of fencing. We get a look at some of the spectators with Bravo, the mascot of these games. And a quick look at some of the preliminary action here in fencing. First up, we'll take a look at the women's Epee individual gold medal match. This features two athletes from Poland, Kamila Pitka and Aleksandra Zamachowska. Pitka on the left, Zamachowska on the right. Pitka was 35th at the recent World Championships. In Epee, you can only score with the point of the blade, but you can score on the entire body. So each of the three disciplines a little different in terms of how you can score and where you can score. For those of you not familiar with fencing, Zamachowska with the 6-3 lead. She'll extend it there to a 4-point advantage. Now 10-4 Zamachowska. Pitka gets one back. Now 13-7, Zamachowska nearing that magic mark of 15. She's now 1 point away. And there it is, 15-8, the final, as Zamachowska wins the gold medal in the women's Epee individual, defeating countrywoman Kamila Pitka.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner.
You'll get a look here momentarily at the winning score right there. And Zamachowska, ecstatic over her win. She wins gold, Pitka wins silver. Two bronze medals, one to Roberta Marzani of Italy, the other to Ksenia Pantelieyeva of Ukraine. And there you have the medalists in the women's Epee. Now to the men's saber individual gold medal bout. This features Enver Yildirim of Turkey and Andras Zatmari of Hungary. Zatmari just won gold at the recent World Championship in Germany and is actually currently ranked third in the world. These two faced each other earlier in the year, with Zatmari defeating Yildirim at the European Championships. Yildirim is ranked 48th in the world and was 52nd at the recent World Championships. In saber, you can only score above the waist, but can score with the entire blade. Zatmari now has built up a 9-5 advantage. Now 12-5. The pack there, Yildirim thought he scored, but it's ruled a point for Zatmari. Now Yildirim needing to make a bit of an adjustment to his blade. Now 14-6, 1 point away, and there it is. Zatmari wins the gold medal at Universiade to continue his fantastic summer. First a gold at the World Championships, now at Universiade as he defeats Enver Yildirim 15-6. And there you see that attack that Yildirim thought he scored on. And the Hungarian team hoisting Zatmari into the air to celebrate his win here in Taipei. So Zatmari wins gold, Yildirim silver. Mohamed Rabari and Mohamed Fatoui of the Islamic Republic of Iran each win bronze medals. Weightlifting here at Universiade taking place at the Tamkang University Memorial Gym. We are getting set for the men's 62 kilogram class. And there you have the athletes as they make their way out. And there you see that start list. First up, we will look at Cao Chan-hung of Chinese Taipei. He was 15th at the World Championships in Thailand back in 2015. Here in the clean and jerk, looking to lift 158 kilograms. Gets under it, and he holds it. A nice lift there for Cao of 158 kilograms.
No lead. 改判失敗.
There you see, just struggled initially to get under it and then got his feet set and was able to hold it. Now, Antonio Vasquez Mendez of Mexico, fifth at the Pan American Games in 2015 in Toronto. He is attempting 165 kilograms. The Universiade record in the clean and jerk is 170 kilograms. Here is Vasquez Mendez. Incredible strength there for the Mexican. Looked fairly easy for him at 165 kilos. I know it wasn't, but great effort there for Vasquez Mendez. And you can see his coach in the background excited about that lift. Now it is Sin Chul Bom of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. He is attempting 171 kilograms. This would be a new Universiad record. He already has the gold medal in his pocket. Can he add a Universiad record? Yes, he does. 171 kilos for Sin Chol Bom of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. Great job there to get under it. There you see his coach, he's very calm in the background. So it'll be gold for Sin with a total of 303 kilos. Vasquez Mendez will win the silver with a total of 290, and Cao of Chinese Taipei, just in behind, wins the bronze with 289 kilos. So there you have the winners here in the men's 62 kilogram class of weightlifting.
It's the time for photos.
Beautiful shot there of Taipei. And you're looking inside at men's volleyball action. The Taiwan University Sports Center. This is Group A, featuring first up the United States and Japan. This is from last night on day one. And we'll get things going here in volleyball. Japan in red, the United States in blue. Bad pass by the U.S. initially sets up Takahiko Imamura with the spike that Enriquez can't control. Now the attack there from Kyle Ensing goes long, and Japan up 21-20. Set point now for the United States, 24-23. The serve of Miles Johnson off the net and lands in, so the Americans take the opening set, 25-23. Now 8-5 in the second set for the United States. Nice dig there by Naoya Tanaka. And that will set up Kenya Fujinaka, who goes off the U.S. block, point Japan. Now set point United States, 24-23. That attack from Imamura goes long, so set two belongs to the United States. You can see no touch there from the Americans. They're now up two sets to none. Japan in the third set, up 14-13. Takano gets a hand on it, and then Yamaguchi just dumps it over the net. Japan up by two. Set point now for Japan, 24-19. And from the back row, Imamura finishes that set off. Japan back in it, down two sets to one. Now to the fifth set, Japan up 2-1. They would win the fourth, 25-18. And there's a nice little tip over the net from Lugo Rodriguez of the United States to knot it up at two. Japan up 10-8 later here in the fifth set. And a huge kill there from Fukuyama. Japan now up 14-9, match point. You'll see some great defense both ways here. Good battle here at the net, but it is ruled point for Japan. A huge comeback for the Japanese, down two sets to none. They come back to defeat the United States, three sets to two, winning the fifth, 15-9. So they take their opening match in Pool A competition. Also in Pool A from last night, Chinese Taipei taking on France. There you see some of the French supporters. 4-3 Chinese Taipei here in the first set. And that attack from Jordan Cortegiani. Wu can't handle it. France ties it up. Move later in the set, 15-13 France up. And that one goes out off of France. And we move a little later here again, 24-19, France now ahead. And that kill from Yassine Louati finishes off the opening set. France wins it 25-19. Now to the second, 16-all. Both teams in scramble mode here. And ultimately, that attack lands in for Chinese Taipei. They move ahead. Now to set point, 26-25, Chinese Taipei. Back pass, and Timothée Cao mistimes his jump a little bit. And that'll give the second set to Chinese Taipei, 27-25, to knock things at one. 18-17 now in the third set, Chinese Taipei in front. Cortegiani, his attack off the net. Chinese Taipei extends its lead, but France would come back, take a 1-point lead. Now it's set point. Nice defense there by Nicolas Rossard. Chinese Taipei thought it was gonna land out, but it catches the line. France takes the third set. Now to the fourth, France up 7-6. That off the French block from Wu. Ties it up at seven. Now 14-10 France. Some great defense by the French. And then Burel with the block extends the French lead to five. Now it's match point. And that serve goes long. France will defeat the host, Chinese Taipei, 3-1. To win their opening match in Pool A action. The French supporters very happy with that result here in Taipei. There is the Yingfeng Riverside Roller Rink. Site of roller sports making its debut at the World University Games here in Taipei. This is the men's 10,000 meter points and elimination final. So this is a bit of a unique race in the sense that athletes will earn points depending on where they are placed first, second, or third as they cross after certain laps. And depending on where they are, if they are last, they will be eliminated at certain laps as well. So you'll actually see athletes drop off over the course of the race. And you can also be in a position where you wouldn't necessarily have to finish cross first on the last lap to win the race, depending on how many points you have earned so far during the competition itself. See in blue there a couple of the Italian racers. Alessio Icono, as well as Giuseppe Bramante. The athletes content here to streamline things a little bit. Now there's the athlete, two athletes from Chinese Taipei, Chen Yang Cheng and Kofu Xuan. Along with the Colombian there in yellow, that is Carlos Perez Cannibal.
Number 45 and 46.
And also in that pack now moving in front, that's the skater from Japan, that is Kengo Kawabata.
Point left.
So again, you will earn points as you cross the line at certain laps, depending on whether you're first, second, or third. And there you see some of the athletes in the middle that have been eliminated. And as the athletes continue to make their way around the track, you can see fatigue setting in. Another warm, humid day. It rained a little bit here this morning in Taipei, so the humidity level a little bit higher. And the legs starting to lock up there a little bit. That's Chen. He continues to push on. And there is Chen. He will cross and will win the first gold medal in roller sports at Universiade in the 10,000 meter points elimination race. Getting congratulations from the big crowd. His countryman, Ko Fu Xuan, will win the silver medal. And the bronze goes to Colombian Carlos Perez Cannavale. Kawabata from Japan will finish fourth. So the host, Chinese Taipei, win gold and silver in the men's 10,000 meter points elimination race.